尊敬的堪萨斯州立大学的各位教授、专家、同学们，你们好。
So a very good afternoon.
美国确实是一个令人向往的地方。这几天的学习让我深深感受到美国的先进文化。
Well, the visitation of this town really impressed me about the excellent teaching practice and the beautiful country. Well, in China, 美国 we call United States of America. In China, it's 美国 Well, literally means a beautiful country. Yeah. It's indeed very, very beautiful. The landscape, the trees, and the forests, and the people. Yeah.
我是来自于中国广东顺德机关幼儿园的副园长梁乐敏。
And associate director from the Shunde, the municipal kindergarten.
能在这里发言，我感到非常的荣幸。
I feel it's an honor to discuss with you today.
首先要感谢各位教授给我提供这样一个平台。
I really appreciate the opportunity you give me to present here.
让我有机会在这里和大家一起分享家园共育的一些做法和心得。
And to share with you my experience and our practice of getting parents to involve in the teaching of children.
今天我引用美国国务卿希拉里的一个著作，叫做《共同建造孩子快乐的家园》，作为我的发言题目。
You say that I would like to call the here is a very famous saying is that we jointly construct the happy life, happy family for the children.
希望能够抛砖引玉，得到大家的帮助。
We hope that we can well discuss and have a learn from each other.
为了建造共同的孩子快乐的家园。我们幼儿园搭建起家园共育的平台。
There's several ways for us to get parents involved to jointly have a joint effort for the education of children.
形成一个幼儿园与家庭互动的一个平台。
And to establish the platform for the kindergarten to interact with families.So it's a kind of a two-way interaction. And there are different approaches. Okay.
首先建立是家委会。
Well, the first approach we use is we set up a call the parents committee in each kindergarten.
它是各个班里面热心幼儿教育、支持幼儿园工作的那些家长。
And parents from each individual classroom, well, usually two or three from each classroom, and they will form a committee for the whole kindergarten. That's called parents committee.
他们在讨论幼儿园的计划。
They are discussing in the and audit the plan, the teaching plan of the kindergarten.
每个学期还有提交给幼儿园关于家园监测方面的一个报告。
And each semester, they will need to write a report and submit to the director about their suggestions and the findings when they audit or the audition. And they can tour the kindergarten at any time. So if they found any problems or have any suggestion, they will write down and they're required to submit the report to the kindergarten for the improvement of the teaching quality.
建立起无纺的制度。
And that's the famous system they call it five visit.
老师在新生入园前要家访，每年要普访，还有幼儿园一天不回来要电话访，家长来的时候巡访，还有就是特殊孩子探访。
Well, they are called the five visit. It means that each time before the children or there's new children get into the kindergarten, before they get into the kindergarten, the teacher need to visit each family. They call it family visitation. Okay, every child. Well, 还没有。
Oh.
And then for this, they need to have, they will have also have an appointment with the parents to visit. And the telephone visitation is that if a child is sick or is not present, if that didn't come to the classroom, the teacher is required to call the parent to check what's wrong with the child. And this one, that's when, when the parents come to pick out the children every day, the teachers need to find time to talk with the parents and to understand the situation of the child at home.
开放 PPT 就是每个家长可以匿名的在网上发表意见。
We also have the internet as accessible to all the parents. The parents can access the internet of the kindergarten and give their suggestions or even critique. Well, it's anonymous. So, okay.
家长开放日。
And that's the open day of the kindergarten.
让家长从早一天跟进孩子 半天的生活的流程。
So the parent can choose to go to the kindergarten and they can follow the, they can join the learning teaching activities.
家园通信就是各个班门前都有关于班级里面最近的一些情况介绍。
And in each class there's a poster, okay, and that's called parent kindergarten communication. So if there's any notes, if there's any important information, the teacher will post it there so that the parents can read while when they come to pick out their children.
家长问卷就是每个家庭家长可以每个学期评价一次
That's the questionnaire and evaluation form for the parents. That means that the parents can have a copy of the evaluation form and then just rate the quality of the service of the kindergarten.
还有对每个教师各方面的一个能力进行一个,
And the parents also will rate the quality of service of teaching of each teaching staff, each teacher.
家庭进入幼儿园的，就是
Well, the other method we use is that we invite the parents to come into kindergartens.
这是我们幼儿园家长委员会，就是每个家长的一个工作证。
Well, this is it's kind of a certificate. Well, it's a car for each committee member. So with this car, the parents can enter the kindergarten, can get into the kindergarten at any time, okay, without prior notification of the kindergarten. So it kind of monitoring the quality with this car. Okay.
他可以凭着这个工作证，不用知会园长就可以随时到各个部门去检查。
They don't need to notify the directors beforehand, and they can check the service at any time.
教师与家长面对面的交流。
Teachers and parents talk face to face.
在网上，家长可以发表他们的意见。
And parents can publish their opinions and their comments of for the kindergarten anonymously.
家长。 进入幼儿园给孩子上课。
The parents are also invited to teach in the kindergarten. They are kind of teach as a volunteer. Well, we also saw a volunteer in the Head Start program. There's an elder. Well, he worked there for two years every day. He go there. In China, the same. The some parents are very enthusiastic, and they. They find time to go to the kindergarten to teach.
这是家长志愿队，他们 自愿成立为幼儿园，做很多的事情。
These are the teams of the parent volunteer. Well, I once attended a very big show. Well, the performance, the children's day performance, and many of the programs are well, they're organized and performed by the parents. Okay, the directors are very relaxing that day because everything is done by the parent.
第二个就是引领家长统一共识，达到协同的教育效果。
Well, besides in the invitation of parents to come into kindergarten, we also provide an education, the parent education, to guide the parents.
我们投放了大量的精力和时间去培训家长。
We do a lot of parent education.
开学前的新生家长的培训。
Well, especially for those whose children, well, just going to the kindergarten, well, the first time. Well, so it's very important.
让他们知道，幼儿时期的教育是为他人生的幸福做准备的。
To let the parents know that the education for a young child is laid a good foundation for their future, so that they will better working together with the kindergarten.They have well, work much more closely.
第二个是毕业生大班家长的一个培训，就是为孩子做好入读小学前的心理和物质上的准备的培训。
Another important time for parent teaching is when the children are ready to get into the elementary school, so that to let the parents know how to help the children to get used to a new life and into a different.Kind of a school, because in China, kindergarten and elementary school are usually separate in two different places. But where the one we visit today, the elementary school, is integrated, is put together. Okay, but in China, it's usually separate in two different places.
还有就是每天我们园长在幼儿园的大门口办公。
And every day, every morning, the directors of the kindergarten will greet the parents at the entrance. So when the parents take their children to get into the kindergarten, they can talk with the teachers and directors very conveniently.
在门口指导孩子家长，然后观察孩子。
And the directors and will observe the interaction of the parent with their children. For example, some parents like to hold their children as they get into the kindergarten, and the directors and teachers will suggest to the parent that they need to let the child walk by themselves, something like that. Yeah.
班级与家长的互动是很频繁的，很多种形式。
There are frequent parent and the teachers interaction.
这是一个小小班级的家长和老师们的一个友谊的篮球比赛。
And that's the basketball competition between the teachers and the parents. So that's one way for them to know each other.
这是我们幼儿园办的三份园报。
And that's the newspaper published in the kindergarten. They edited and they published and they circulated.So that they will have all the information there on the newspaper and have it available for the parents to take back home.
倡导给每个孩子提供一个自由活动的区间和创作的一个空间。
And we also dedicate to provide free spaces and creative spaces for the children, so that they can you know to create their work.
父母是孩子的第一任老师，特别倡导父亲参与孩子的教育。
We also agree that the parents is first teacher of the children, especially we recommend the paternal involvement. That father is very important. So we have done a lot to encourage the fathers to get involved in the education process of the children.
赠阅好书以及推荐一些教育的一个书籍给家长， 提升他们的自我学习的意识。
Well, for parent education, we also recommend some books for children, for parents to read. Okay.
有效地利用社会资源，扩展孩子的视野。
And we try to maximize the community resources.
嗯，这是邀请了作为交警的那医生的那个家长来给孩子们上课。
Well, you invite the parent who is a doctor to come to the kindergarten and teach the children.
这个是军人来上课。
Well, this is a policeman. Well, a firefighter. Well, they show the children how to make beds.
这是一个祖辈家长的讲座。
This is a lecture about grandparenting. So they have different kinds of method to interact with parents.
第四个就是丰富的亲子活动，让家长和孩子同欢乐共成长。
Well, another important way is that in China they usually organize different sports games. Here you can see many people, a lot of people, and they have a game. Well, parents will join the game and play together with children and teachers.
这里家长和孩子加起来有1000多个人。
There are over 1,000 people.Again, yeah.
在郊野的趣味运动会。
Yeah, and a picnic. Yeah. Well, I think the 1,000 sometimes is the equivalent to the whole population of the town here, right?
这个是亲子的爱心需欲的活动，就是培养孩子那个理财的意识。
Well, that's the way that it's kind of a market and.So parents and teachers, parents and children will sell their things, well, just like small market, and to give them a sense of financial planning yeah, and consumption.
结合节日的庆典活动，培养孩子的感恩意识。
Well, that's the kind of, with the holidays and to cultivate the children'sSense of being thankful for the other people, for the parents, for the other people, be grateful. Yeah.
这里是地球一小时低碳的活动。
Okay, that's about environment protection.
亲子表演就是家长和孩子一起同台表演。
And parents and teachers have a performance together.
还有各种的亲子活动。都是家庭和孩子，家长和孩子一起共同参与的活动。
Different sorts of parent and child activities. They work together, play together.
下面请大家观赏一下我们的那个
亲
子活动的视频。
I'd like to show you a video about how the parents and children and teachers work together. That's the last video show. Yeah, with that.
最大化怎么样？是最大化吗？已经开始了。这也是家长和孩子一起共同同台表演的一个六一的晚会。
That's a Children's Day performance. The parents and their children perform together. They're singing the poems of the Asian poems. What is another one? Is the
每一个大班的孩子都是仪仗队员。
especially many, many group activities. And they only invite the people from the military, from the, yeah, to join them. Are you ready? We are ready.
Those are 大班六岁的孩子.
That's about 6 years old. Kind of military training. You see in China that many of the actions are pretty, you know, the same. It's a drill.
这是退伍军人在训练孩子。
Shunde is the, we call it the home of Kung Fu in China. Because Jackie Lee. So many, many children can speak to English. And they invite many teachers from the other countries, from the United States, from England, to teach English in China. They play the English song. and dramatic play, right, in English. So the English is very important, foreign language. You can always see a very, very group of, a big group of people.
一共有600个孩子.
There are over 600 children there. Playground. That's a graduation ceremony. That children, that's
孩子是我们的挚爱.
Children, we love you, and we love your child. And the education process must be very happy for the children. It must be happy for the child, for the teacher.
要不动的.
Okay.
有没有还有的吗？
差不多。So thank you for your presentation, and thank you very much.
请大家莅临李小龙的故乡。
We would like to invite you to visit our kindergarten and in Shunde with Dr. Meredith visits in May with several other students. We really wish that you can go there. And the last thing, to summarize, the idea is to cherish the only childhood years. That's the ideology of the director, Director Liu of the kindergarten. And we are very pleased to be here today and to share our understanding of early childhood education with you. And we also feel very happy to come here to learn from you in this several days of visitation. And so thank you very much. If you have any time, and we are pleased to ask, well, if you have any questions, we are pleased to answer.
We'd like to take the final few minutes to answer any questions that you might have, anything that provoked your thinking as you were observing the videos. And so do you have any questions?
Yeah, whatever question will be fine. Either it's about early childhood education or other things.
Okay. And if you could come up, because we have a camera going.
You might regret.
I just wanted to ask, in the center with the different rooms, like the art room and the sensory integration room, do all the children go in there at a scheduled time, or do they get to say, I want to go into a certain room and then go explore in there?
Okay, good. 刚才讲到那个，关于讲, 我们讲到就是, 分区啊, 就是我们分有不同的区, 有那个感统区啦, 有那个, 这些, 艺术区, 是吧? 有分为四个区嘛。 那么这个分区的话呢, 小朋友是他们在规定的时间去那个区呢, 还是说他们随时想去都可以去?
There are
two different situations, because our kindergarten is a boarding kindergarten, and the children are in the kindergarten from Monday, in the morning on Monday, all the way to Friday afternoon.
这两段时间呢，其实是一个就是正规的一种学习的时间，一种是非正规的一种学习时间。
And there are two different kinds of learning, she said. One is informal, and the other is formal learning.
比如说早上就属于正常的一种正规的一种学习时间。For example,
in the morning is kind of formal.
老师呢就会相应的有一个预设的计划，去引导孩子进入区域的学习。So
in the morning, you will more be teacher directed, or teacher will plan, will schedule.
到晚上的时候，孩子是全开放的、自由的选择。So
in the evening, the children will have much more freedom to make their choice, so they can choose whatever they want to do. But in the morning, then they will need to follow the schedule.
我不知道我这样，就是说明这个问题，明白没有？
I answer your questions or not. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Any other questions?
We
really appreciate your okay.
Mr. Varick.
Yeah,
my question is, in the United States, there's a lot of children who have behavioral problems,
okay.
Attention deficit hyperactive disorder, mm-hmm. learning disabilities. Mm-hmm. How common is that in China, and how do you guys handle those?
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, very tough question. 他说呢，在美国，我们在座的园长都可以回答哈，就是在美国的话呢，有很多的这种孩子的行为问题，比如说多动症，就是注意力缺失啦，那么。 那么他想问一个问题，是说在我们中国是不是也有类似的这样一些行为，这些问题？那么如果有的话，我们是怎么来处理？怎么来解决这些问题的？我们做些什么？哪位园长来都可以啊。OK，Dr. Liang will address the question.
我们让孩子随班就读，就是那些孩子呢，就经过医生诊断了以后。 我们会给他一个个性化的一个教育的方案。如果是一些生理有一些障碍的，大脑是正常的，就我们就让他家庭派家长或者请一个助教来幼儿园
Okay. Well, Director Liang's kindergarten is a kind of inclusive education program. And so the children with special needs, like hyperactive attention deficit, they will have a special therapist for the child. And if it's diagnosed and it's very serious, the doctor thinks that it's a very, very serious problem, then you will be referred to a special school. Okay, well, so there are two ways. One is not that severe, then you will be together with the other children and there will be a therapist and assigned to help the parents and the children, okay, the child. And if it's diagnosed as very severe problem, then we'll be referred to the special school. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Are there other questions?
Anything? Well, on the blackboard, I have some questions about only child policy and the family planning policy. I don't know whether you still have those questions or those questions have been solved.
Questions about the one child policy.
Okay.
Message board.
Yeah, message board. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Have you any questions about?
Or we can discuss later on with the other directors, or we can talk later. Okay. Yeah, if there's not.
I would like to ask the directors to come up.
Sure. Okay.
Yeah.
We would like the directors to come up. You can come up. Hu院长, 他们有些小的那个纪念品要送给你们啊。We
greatly appreciate the presentation that you have given today. It has been very informative for us. And as I said, this is a wonderful opportunity not only for you to visit us and learn about our programs, but for us to visit you. Not everyone will have the opportunity, at least right away, to go to China. And so this is one of the ways that we can learn from you, and you have wonderful things to share. We've learned a lot. So I'd like to express my appreciation to each one of you. Thank you.
十分感谢大家，今天有个机会，那么让大家展示那种中国的，让我们大家向中国的学生教育学习。那么下面一些小小的礼物，献给大家。Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So.